Good morning, everyone. It's good to see you. I haven't seen you since you were drinking my whiskey at the table. I seem to remember. At the wedding. Right. A warm welcome to Miller and Miller's family, who's going to be baptised today. Lovely to see you all. Thank you for coming. To celebrate the Queen's Platinum Jubilee, Octoless Church are having a hosting a soup and a cheese and biscuits lunch on Sunday the 5th of June in the church at 12:45 p.m. The service will be from 11:30, but if you just want to come for the soup and the lunch, then it starts at 12:45, and that's open to the community. But if you can, let us know if you'd like to come, just so we can get an idea of numbers. We've got some stragglers coming in. They're trying to sneak in without being noticed. So that's... But if you can let us know by next Sunday, that would be wonderful. But you're all welcome to come. Right, so... I was told by Eric Stephen, the reason he wasn't in church last week, him and Nora, is because they had the 60th wedding anniversary, their diamond wedding. I don't know if I believe them, but I'll just have to take your word, Eric, unless we've got proof. Is there any proof? You've got proof, have you? Oh, hang on a minute. So this is Eric and Nora, last week, celebrating 60 years of marriage with the Queen's bodyguard there, the Lord Lieutenant. She would have come in person, but she missed the bus. So we hope you have a lovely day. And 60 years is a very, very long time. And I just hope that you like each other. No, I heard you had a lovely day, though. Right, then, let's begin. Our first hymn is it's called Here Is Love, Vast As the Ocean. It's a Welsh hymn. It's got two verses. The first two verses are sung in Welsh, and then the same two verses are sung in English.
Never
Right then, the children can join in our prayers. So let's join our hearts and together let's pray. Almighty God, loving Father, source of all light and love, we thank you for calling us to worship, to meet together as brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, and glued together by the power of your Holy Spirit. Father, as we worship you together, grace us by your presence. Fill this place and each of our hearts with the Holy Spirit. Bind us together in love. Lord, you commanded us to love one another, and we ask for your forgiveness wherever we have failed to carry out your commandment with unkind thoughts, unkind words, unkind deeds, and kindness not shown when it was needed. So, Lord, forgive us this day, we pray. And we ask then for strength so that we may love as you love and forgive as you forgive. For these things we pray in and through Christ Jesus, our Lord and Saviour. Amen. Our next hymn is Morning Has Broken. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Jesus called for the children and said, "Let the children come to me. Do not try to stop them, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as these." In the sacrament of baptism, the love of God is offered to each one of us, though we cannot understand it or explain it. We are called, though, to accept that love with the openness and trust of a child. In baptism, Miller is assured of the love that God has for him, and the sign and seal of the Holy Spirit is placed upon him. Sarah and Gordon, in presenting this child for baptism, desiring that he may be grafted into Christ as a member of his body, the church, do you receive the teaching of the Christian faith which we confess in the Apostles' Creed? If you can stand to recite the Apostles' Creed, please do, but if stay seated if you feel more comfortable. Thank you, Sam. Okay. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the whole universal church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please be seated. Miller, for you, Jesus Christ came into the world. For you, he lived and showed God's love. For you, he suffered the darkness of Calvary. For you, he triumphed over death and rose in newness of life. For you, he ascended to reign at God's right hand. All this he did for you, Miller, though you do not know it yet. And so the word of Scripture is fulfilled. We love because God first loved us. Let's pray. We thank you, gracious God, for your gifts of water and the Holy Spirit. Send your Holy Spirit upon us and upon this water, that Miller, being buried with Christ in baptism, may rise with him to newness of life, and being born anew of water and the Holy Spirit, may remain forever in the number of your faithful children. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be all honour and glory, now and forever. Amen. We'd like to come out. Miller Gordon Ingram, I baptize you in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. May God descend upon you now, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and dwell in your heart forever. Amen. Now we're just going to have a sung blessing, and you can show Miller. From this day she will be, he will be at home in the community, and there will always be a place for him here. Tell him of his baptism, unfold to him the treasure he has been given today, so that he may know he's been baptized. And as he grows, he'll be able to make his own response to faith in love, and come in due time to share in the communion around the Lord's table. Sarah and Gordon, do you promise, depending on the grace of God, to teach Miller the truths and duties of the Christian faith, and by prayer and example, to bring him up in the life and worship of the church? Thank you. Now then, Keith and Jen, it's a great honor and privilege to be godparents, but also a responsibility too. And I must say, my own godmother had a very important part to play in my coming to faith, and I'm always grateful to her. Her name is Elizabeth Braford. She's no longer with us, but she always is in my thoughts. And so, as Miller's godparents, do you promise to nurture his spiritual life, depending on the grace of God, to teach Miller the truths and duties of the Christian faith, by prayer and by example? Thank you. You who are gathered here represent the whole universal church. Word and sacrament bring you the joy of Christ's presence in your midst. They also bring us responsibilities as Christ's people in this place. Do you welcome Miller, and do you renew your commitment with God's help to live before all God's children in a kindly and Christian way, and to share with them the knowledge and love of Christ? Thank you. We will nurture one another in faith, uphold one another in prayer, encourage one another in service. Let's join our hearts in prayer. Let's pray. God of love, we rejoice again to receive your grace in word and sacrament. We have heard your call and are made new by your Spirit. Guide and guard Miller all his days. May your love hold him, your truth guide him, your joy delight him. Bless his parents that he may grow up in a secure and happy home. Give to his family wisdom and courage laughter and peace, and the love that endures all things. And gracious God, touch us all again this day with the grace of our baptism. For these things we ask in and through the name of Christ Jesus, our Lord and Saviour, in whose name we pray, and we further pray together the prayer he taught us, as we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Amen. I'll just present you with... We're just now going to turn to the Word of God and the Scriptures. First to John's Gospel, the night before he died, after Jesus had shared the Last Supper and washed the disciples' feet. And then after Judas had left, Jesus said, "Now the Son of Man's glory is revealed. Now God's glory is revealed through him. And if God's glory is revealed through him, then God will reveal the glory of the Son of Man in himself, and he will do so at once. My children, I shall not be with you very much longer. You will look for me, but I tell you now what I told the Jewish authorities. You cannot go where I am going. And now I give you a new commandment: love one another. As I have loved you, so you must love one another. If you have love for one another, then everyone will know that you are my disciples." Our second reading is just a short reading from Paul's letter, second letter to Timothy, where he says, this was just before he knew the end was nigh, before he was dispatched, so to speak, by the Roman authorities. And he said, "I have done my best in the race. I have run the full distance, and I have kept the faith." Amen. Thanks be to God for his word for us this day. You can open them, you know. Have you opened them? Or have they got to stay clean? Right then. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Coming to the end of a Spanish cross-country race, Fernandez Anaya was second behind a Kenyan Olympic bronze medal winner. He knew we couldn't close the gap to win the race, but then the Kenyan stopped, thinking he crossed the finish line, whereas in actual fact he was 10 metres short. So Fernandez soon closed the gap, but he didn't overtake the Kenyan and win the race. Instead, not speaking his language, he gestured the Kenyan to carry on and cross the line. Afterwards, the trainer of Fernandez thought it was stupid not to take advantage of the Kenyan's mistake. But Fernandez said he was the rightful winner. He created a gap that I couldn't have closed. I didn't deserve to win it. I did what I had to do. He was the rightful winner. He created a gap that I couldn't have closed if he hadn't have made a mistake. As soon as I saw him stop, I knew I wasn't going to pass him. Fernandez didn't win the race, but he did win a lot of admiration for his gracious gesture. The Apostle Paul likens the Christian life to a race, but it's no ordinary race where we try and outrun other people to beat our competitors. It's a race that doesn't require us to have anything better than anyone else in the race, for this race is without competition. In fact, if we feel we have to be competitive to do better than our fellow Christians, to outshine them in some way, then we run this race with shoes made of lead. When the Apostle Paul realized the end was near and he would soon be dispatched by the hand of the Romans, he wrote, "I have fought the good fight, I have finished the race, I have kept the faith." The race metaphor is not one of winning, but of finishing the race. It's used as an example of persevering when the going gets tough. The object of this race is not to outshine other people, but to shine with the love of Christ. Jesus said, "I give you a new commandment, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, you also should love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another." If you have love for one another. The phrase "one another" is used 58 times in the New Testament, in such ways as greet one another, bear with one another, carry one another's burdens, be devoted to one another, love one another. It's the one another's in the Bible that tell us that our faith is not about me only, but it's about us together. The Christian then is in a race, but it's not a competitive race. It's a race where we link arms to support one another, to encourage one another, to bear one another's burdens. In other words, to simply love one another. Jesus said, "Love one another as I have loved you." The disciples experienced Christ's love to them as selfless, sacrificial, and a love that came with understanding, acceptance, and forgiveness. Can you remember when Monty Python used to be on television and they do the sketch shows? You can tell people's ages now, can't you? Anyway, Monty Python would do sketch shows and they would do all sorts of things. And one week they did the Silly Olympics. And they had things like, in the Silly Olympics, they had the swimming event, 50-meter swimming event, for non-swimmers. So the non-swimmers dived in and they didn't get any further. And then there was the 100-meter sprint for people without a sense of direction. So the gun went off and they all ran here, there and everywhere, except the way they were meant to go. Fortunately for us, we've been given a sense of direction. We know the path that we should follow. We know the direction that we should take. Love one another as I have loved you, said Jesus. When we read the Gospels, we see that Christ's love was servant-like, it was selfless, it was sacrificial, and it came with understanding, acceptance, and forgiveness. It's not always easy to love one another, to obey this commandment. We will fall short, but when we fall, we're not out of the race. The love of Christ lifts us up again, and we carry on. We may fall again, because to love one another is a challenge. It's a challenge because we're not asked only to love those people that we like, those people that we get on with, but to love one another, whether they irritate us, whether they try our patience, or whether they have hurt our feelings. That's where the love of Christ comes, to understand people, to accept them and forgive them. So the Christian is not in a race to outshine each other, but to shine with the love of Christ. The Apostle Paul knew this, and therefore he writes much about it. And the well-known passage that is often used at weddings is one such case. It's not specifically about marriage or romantic love, but it is about love. And he says, love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It does not dishonor others, it's not self-seeking, it's not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, it always trusts, it always hopes, it always perseveres. Love never fails. I love that passage. Some of the writings of Paul, you know, they're not easy to understand, and some of them, they don't roll off your tongue. But he also wrote some sublime passages, and that is one of them. And I wish I could say that I loved like that all the time, but I don't. But the passage and those words of Jesus, they remind us when we're going off in the wrong direction. They're like a signpost saying, this is the way, walk in it. And they also remind us that I cannot run this race on my own, in my own strength. I need the Lord's help, and I need your help too. At the Monty Python Silly Olympics, the sprinters with no sense of direction, they run off here, there, and everywhere. But to love one another as Christ loves us gives us a sense of direction. But to love one another as Christ loves us is given that description in Paul's letter. He tells us how we can do it. And so let's just listen to it again before we finish. Love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It does not dishonor others, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, it always hopes, it always trusts, it always perseveres. Love never fails. The aim of this race is not to outshine each other, but to shine with the love of Christ for each other. Amen. Our next hymn is Day by Day.
Day by day, and with each passing moment, strength I find to meet my trials here. Trusting in the Father's wise bestowment, I have no cause for worry or for fear. Whose heart is kind beyond all measure, gives unto each day what he deems best. Lovingly, it's part of pain and pleasure, mingling toil with peace and rest. Is near me with a special mercy for each hour. All my cares he fain would bear and cheer me. He whose name is Counselor and Power. The protection of his child and treasure is a chart that on himself he laid. As thy days, thy strength shall be in measure. This the pledge to me he has made.
Join our hearts in prayer. Let's pray together. Loving Father, all good things we have come from you, and we acknowledge your goodness to us through our worship, in doing service for you, and in our giving. So, Lord, accept then our offerings given for your joy, given to do good works for your kingdom, and given for the preaching of the gospel in this place and beyond. Father, we thank you this day for your Son, Jesus Christ, who is the way, the truth, and the life. Give us grace to love one another and walk in the way of his commands. Oh, Father, when will all the people embrace the way of love? We pray the evil and darkness in the world that has captured so many hearts and minds, we pray against it, Lord, that it would change into light and love. We pray that the voices in the church in Russia who are against the war in Ukraine will be heard above those voices in the church who support it. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. Lord, you have shown to us the path to follow. We thank you that we don't have to run this race without a sense of direction, for you guide us by your Spirit through your word in the scriptures and the inner word spoken in our hearts. We thank you that we don't have to run this race in our own strength, but that you strengthen us in our weakness. And we thank you for the support we have from each other, that we're able to support each other and run this race together. Lord, we give you thanks for little Miller. We ask you to bless him and his family. May he grow up to shine with the love of Jesus. And as we go about the coming week, bring to our thoughts those people and situations that need our prayers, those who may need a visit. Reveal to our hearts the needs of others so that we may pray and act with power and assurance from you. For these things we pray in the name above all names, Christ Jesus, our Lord and Saviour. Amen. Our final hymn then is Ancient Words Ever True.
Holy
May the peace that passes all understanding guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus, and the blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you all this day and forevermore. And all the people said together, Amen. Well, thank you for joining with us today and seeing little Miller getting baptized. God bless you, and I hope you have a blessed week.